Hello?
Oh my God, did you hear?
Oh, I'm itching to tell you something.
Itching to tell you with Zoe Ryan.
Today I'm itching to tell you about emollients and how to use them properly when treating your psoriasis. It's so important to incorporate an emollient into your treatment regime when treating plaque psoriasis and especially psoriasis of the scalp. And the reason for that being that psoriasis essentially has two layers. That outer layer, that white, thick, built-up plaque layer that we see, and then below that there's a raised red layer. Now that raised red layer is actually the layer that you have to get to in order for the treatment that you're applying to be effective. And the problem is that if you're just lashing on your prescribed lotions and potions onto that white thick layer, at any one time you've got up to 10 layers of skin there and it's just not getting down to the red layer which it needs to reduce that inflammation. Your emollient softens and loosens those outer thick layers of plaque and it gets it ready for you to be able to lift them and remove them off your scalp and for your skin to be ready to take in your prescribed treatment. The reason why I want to tell you about emollients today is that when I was first diagnosed with psoriasis of the scalp, I wasn't told how to use emollients. For years, I was just layering on loads of different types of topical ointments, steroids and non-steroid. They weren't having the effect that they should have. And it's because I was leaving out that step of using an emollient. I actually found out about using an emollient by complete random accident. I remember I was doing an interview with a GP and in between scenes we were just chatting away and psoriasis just happened to come up in conversation and she was the one that said to me about using the emollient and she was like, yeah, you know, when you're combing it out. And I was like, what? Absolutely mind blown. This makes so much more sense in my head now that you should comb it out and therefore it'll be more effective. But the thing was, I wasn't told, so therefore I was completely unaware and I was treating my psoriasis for about 6 years without knowing it, not seeing much results at all. And to be completely honest with you, my psoriasis at that point was really, really severe. It was gone really thick, very white, so much to an extent that like when you looked at it, you could see this ultra white halo around me. It was so thick and built up and it was coming down my forehead to about here at the time, all down the back of my ears and the back of my neck, and very, very visual. And I was extremely self-conscious of it. It got to a stage, I remember, where one day I was at an outside broadcast for work and I was so conscious of how white it was along my scalp, and I thought that everybody was looking at it, and I really found it knocked my confidence. So I wanted to tell you today about using an emollient because immediately I found that it really was a game changer. Absolutely changed the way that I treat my psoriasis and more importantly, how I feel about having psoriasis. It's improved the appearance of my psoriasis so much that I'm just not as self-conscious anymore. And that is something that I just wanted to share with you. Okay, so I'm going to talk you through now how to use the emollient. Just a few quick and easy steps. First of all, you're going to want to pick your emollient of choice. Now, I tried a lot of different emollients over the years, and without a doubt, the best one, the most effective one I found is coconut oil. Any coconut oil at all. Doesn't matter how cheap or how expensive it is, it's going to do the exact same job. Now, this one that I'm using at the moment is called Ovel, and it just happens that it actually is from a chemist. I usually use one that is from the Euro Giant shop, and it's £1.50. Or even use the ones from supermarkets. You know, the likes of Lidl and Aldi, that you can get the big jar of it for like £2.99 or £3.99, and it's actually for cooking. That'll do the exact same thing. There is no difference between buying the cheapest of the cheap coconut oil and a really expensive one. They do the exact same thing. The cheaper the better, to be quite honest with you, because you're going to be using so much of it so frequently, you're going to get through the tub really quickly. You get your coconut oil or whatever moisturizer emollient that you want to use. Apply it anywhere that you have the plaque psoriasis. I find it's actually quite difficult to get all the plaques at the back of my scalp, so you might have to ask somebody else to help you. Absolutely no shame in that. I asked my mum to do it, in the past I've asked friends or partners, whoever you want. You might need somebody to help you. Just make sure they get all the parts. Put on loads of it, lash it on. Really work it into the scalp and you'll notice that the longer you leave it in, the softer the plaque actually gets and the easier it is to lift. I leave it in overnight. I find the leaving in overnight is the best, because if you're going into work, you don't want to be going in with this emollient in your hair, because obviously it's going to make your hair look oily and it's going to make it look greasy. And definitely in my line of work, I can't be going into the studios with my hair looking like it's not washed. Do it at the weekend. If you're working Monday to Friday, put it in at the weekend. What I like to do as well is the next morning, maybe I'll apply another lot of it. Same thing all over again, just to get another lashing of it in there. This is the most important step now. Fine tooth comb. So what you need the fine tooth comb is to come along and gently remove the psoriasis from your scalp. I find the best fine tooth combs are actually the head lice combs that you get in any pharmacy. Yet again, really inexpensive. Now, I know you can get the little steel ones. They might be a little bit harsh on your scalp. I just use the plastic one, and it's got the two different size teeth on it. The smaller teeth you can get, the better. Any fine tooth comb, I just find that the head lice one is really handy. So come along with your fine tooth comb and you're just gonna gently run it along your scalp. Now, I say gently, do not force the psoriasis. I know how tempting it is if, like me, you've had psoriasis for such a long time and then you see it all lifting off the scalp. You're like, this is great, let me rip my whole scalp off. No, don't do that, okay? Go around your head 3-4 times, whatever it takes. You'll notice each time you go around, less and less is coming off on the comb. And then you'll realize that it gets to a stage where you think, okay, I've gotten any bits that are gonna come off. Usually what I do is I'll have maybe a piece of kitchen roll in my hand and I'll be going along with it, wipe it on the kitchen roll, because otherwise you're gonna have lumps of oily psoriasis all over the place. But sure, what of it? Go around with Hoover afterwards. Don't just kind of drag it to about halfway here, okay? Especially if you have long hair like me, what you're going to do then is you're going to cause a couple of knots in your hair. So when you're actually dragging it from the scalp, make sure you drag it the whole way through down to the tip and let the pieces of psoriasis fall off, okay? Otherwise, you're going to still have lumps of psoriasis in your hair when you're washing it out, which isn't ideal. Now, there will be some stubborn bits that are really stuck into your head that won't come off, but don't worry about them, okay? The worst thing you can do is actually to really dig into the scalp and scrape them off, because you'll actually cause more damage than good. It's likely that you could cause it to scar. And if scar tissue grows where you're after ripping, it's really hard, or maybe even near impossible, for your hair to grow back through it. If there's any little pieces that haven't come out, just say to yourself, I've gotten all the bits that I can get today, I'll get that the next day. Because you can be sure that the coconut oil or the emollient you're after putting onto it today has loosened it. It's just, it's been a bit more stubborn than the other bits, and you'll get it the next day. It's not enough to just apply the emollient and wash your hair out. That's the problem I made for years. I was applying all these ointments and these emollients, leaving them in overnight, a couple of days, whatever people were telling me to do, and I wasn't scraping it out. And because I was missing that essential step, didn't it? I may as well have not walked around with coconut oil in my hair for 2 days, because barely anything came out. So after you're finished going around with your fine tooth comb, wash your hair. You will need to wash your hair, unfortunately, maybe 3-4 times, especially if you're using the coconut oil, because it's really hard to get the oil out of your hair. Especially if you have long hair like me, the longer you leave the oils in your hair, they'll actually start to travel down your hair. So you'll notice you may have only applied them to the scalp area, but if you leave it in for a day or two, or even overnight, you'll notice that it'll travel down your hair. And so you'd really need to wash it. So yes, it is annoying, but definitely so worth it. Now, it depends on the strength of your shampoo as well. If you use quite a weak, gentle shampoo on your scalp, that might need a couple of more washes. They're meant to be gentle on your scalp, so therefore they're not very aggressive. So after you've washed and dried your hair, that's when your scalp is now ready for you to apply your prescribed treatment, whether that be an ointment or a cream, whatever lotion or potion it is, steroid or non-steroid base, that's when you apply it. You'll look at your scalp and you'll see that the majority of that white, thick, scaly layer is actually gone, and what's been left exposed is that red raised layer. That's perfect. That is the red raised layer that you want to get to. You'll be able to apply your treatment directly to it, and therefore it'll be more effective. And that's it. It's as simple as that. A couple of quick and easy steps. So we have that you apply the emollient, leave it on for as long as you can, overnight if possible, and if you can, apply it a second time, gently removing it with a fine tooth comb, please do not force it to come out. I promise you, you'll get it the next time. Then wash your hair out and dry it. And then once it's dry, apply your prescribed treatment, whatever type of topical ointment that is. So five simple, easy steps. And I'm telling you, that very first time that I tried the emollient, I saw results instantly. Immediately, I saw such an improvement in the visual appearance of my psoriasis. And that's what it's all about. Like, let's just be honest here. If you're like me, you've been trying different treatments and ointments for years. When you don't see any results after a couple of days, maybe even give it a couple of weeks, if you don't see a result pretty shortly after using the treatment, you're just going to stop and you're going to move on to the next. So for me, using the emollient was such a game changer because immediately I could see the effects it was having. I could see the results it was having. And I was so happy with the results. Literally, I'd say that first time, about 70% of the plaque that was on my scalp removed. Now the thing is, it has to be maintained. If I were to stop applying the emollient and scraping it off, washing it out, my psoriasis would grow back like absolute lightning. For a few weeks, maybe every time I was washing my hair, I would go through the process of applying the emollient. But then, you know, you'll find that you need to do it less and less. Now I'd say I only do it once every week, maybe even every 2 weeks. And more importantly, I have found that sometimes I actually find that I leave out that last step, which is the applying your prescribed treatment, because I found that just using the emollient and scraping it out alone has improved the appearance of my psoriasis so much that I don't feel the need to apply the steroid cream as much as I once did. Every time you use the emollient, that less and less of the psoriasis is growing back, that it just really halts it at its production stage, that it just doesn't get a chance to grow back, because what you're doing is you're getting rid of that top white layer and then you're treating the red layer. And it's just slowing down it being able to grow back again, which is exactly what you want. I don't know why I wasn't told about emollients the day that I was diagnosed with psoriasis. I should have been told, because it honestly is such a game changer in how you treat your psoriasis. But however, I wasn't. I've discovered it, and now I want to tell you about it so that to save you from going through years of applying ointments and wondering why have they not been working. I really hope that has opened up a couple of few people's eyes as to why their treatments were not working over the years. A very important part in treating your psoriasis, in my opinion, is understanding your condition. And I feel that if you understand it better, you can tailor your treatment process to it. So my advice would be, is go away and try the emollient. Just try it. If you haven't tried it before, or if you haven't tried it with including the step about scraping it out with a fine tooth comb, which I was doing for years, go away today, try an emollient, leave it in for as long as you can, gently remove it, and wash your hair and see if there's a difference. If you feel like you've exhausted all avenues in treating your psoriasis and you're at the end of your tether and going, there's nothing more I can do here, that's it, it's never going anywhere, please do try the emollient, because I saw such results immediately from it. And it really has changed the way I treat my psoriasis, and more importantly, how I view and feel about living with psoriasis.
Till next week. For more information on this topic, check out Itching to Tell You on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And tune in weekly for new episodes. Like, comment, and subscribe.